this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. For years and years and years, I have wanted a bat house. Yes, I know, bats, people are afraid of them. They are so helpful that I have wanted one in our garden to get rid of the mosquitoes. So today at the Brookfield Farmers Market, we came upon Bernie, who is the best salesman of her husband Jim's woodworking achievements. And this is a fantastic bat house, excuse me. It has the crawling area that they want. It's the right dimensions, and it's going to work perfect on that pole behind me, which we've had up there for years, just waiting for some Aryan kind of creature to call home. So we've done our research. We know that this has to be anchored at a certain height and in a certain position so that it catches the sun. Now, we can't drill through here, obviously, so somehow you have to attach it. So we're putting eye hooks here on each side, and then you've drilled through the bottom, so that'll be anchored right into the tree trunk itself. Just so you know, bats can eat 1,000 mosquito-sized insects per hour each night. So just consider that. If you had 1,000 mosquitoes in your yard in 1 hour, one little tiny bat could eat them. They're also very helpful for eating other kinds of insects besides mosquitoes. They help pollinate. Many of the bats just eat fruit nectar and survive on fruit. So they pollinate, they eat insects, and they also disperse seeds, which are that's a very important aspect of their job. Some of them, this 1% of them, eat small birds and frogs and mice. Now, you may have heard about vampire bats, but even though they only live in Latin America, even they have a purpose, because their blood clotting enzyme that they have in their bodies has helped scientists develop things for people with strokes that help prevent blood clotting. So bats are very important. We're going to have some. We saw one the other day during the daytime, so he was just looking for his new home.
So you're going to hang this like a picture frame, which means you're going to add two eye hooks, one on each side.
Yep, got that.
And then have a wire system that hangs in the back. And then you're going to have probably an open hook way at the top that the wire can attach to. And then to really anchor it in place, you're going to have probably a long deck-type screw to anchor and keep it supported to the tree directly.
Right, so it's not swinging. Now, it has to be in a place that gets 6 to 8 hours of direct sunlight. They like to be warm. They're supposed to be 20 to 30 feet away from trees where their predatory birds might get them. We're not going to be able to do that because we just have way too many trees. But I think if it's out in the open like this, you know, perhaps that'll discourage them. And it's supposed to be between 10 and 20 feet above ground level, 12 to 20 being the ideal. So our son Skye is going to be the brave one to climb up there on the ladder and install it for us.
Okay, well, let's get started.
This is my first eyelet that went in on the side. I'm going to put another one on the other side. Then I'm taking, this is picture wire, picture hanging wire that you would hang in your home. And I'm wrapping it around so that it's very tight. And the weather and the wind is not going to blow it away or loosen it up.
Or fall on somebody's head.
Or fall on my head. Okay. Then it'll go up and over to the other one. This will be anchored into the tree or the post, whatever you're anchoring, so that it'll hold it from the back, like this. Okay.
So it's kind of like hanging a picture frame in
a
wall, but you're actually doing it on a tree.
Correct. So Now I need to drill the other hole. I love all my assistants.
Pre-marked.
Pre-marked, pre-measured. Started. And use a screwdriver.
Kind of like brain surgery.
Hope not.
And put it in tightly. As tight as it can go.
Perfect.
Okay. Thank you. Alright, then I'm gonna bring my wire.
Yeah, that one's going like this, so.
Oh, okay. Bring my wire in from the top. Leave enough hanging room over here for my hook. Yep. And then it's gonna be harder than it was on the other side because now it has to go through here. And wrap around. Okay, well, that's gonna have to be looser. There we go. Okay, so it's just a matter of wrapping it around, keeping it tight. Always good for your fingernails, but the bats will be happy.
In the belfry?
Not in my belfry. Okay, plenty. And now we're going to just cut off the excess. Much better. Okay, so that'll be perfect. That goes into the tree. Then this is the screw with the washer that will go at the bottom through the bat house and right into the tree trunk. So that this is going nowhere. Then about once a year you have to check and make sure that there's no water leaking in because of warpage or whatever. Bats like it to be dry where they are. So,
well, that's easy enough to do just by running a bead of caulk along the edges wherever water could penetrate, but you do have an overhang on there.
Right, so it's very, very well built bat house. I'm very pleased with it.
Well, they had other houses. I love their Martin house too, that had eight different compartments and both sides, both flaps open.
Yes, for cleaning. That, so it was a lovely one.
That may be our next project.
Well, you like that one with the little crooked roof.
Oh, yeah, the alpine, the crooked alpine birdhouse. Mm-hmm. That was cool.
That was very cute. Hmm.
Okay, well, let's get up into the tree.
You have the drill.
Bring the tools. Here we go.
that?
Yep.
It's up. Isn't it gorgeous? I hope the bats will love it. Rick says maybe we'll have to get the bat light out to invite the bats to Gotham City. But once they're here, they don't like light at night, so we'll have to turn it off. For now, it's there. They'll find it, I hope. We've seen, Skye was saying he and his friends saw three the other night, so maybe they'll see it tonight when they're out flying around, and they will take up residence. So give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this, learned something, invite bats into your yard, you'll get rid of your mosquitoes. And always, we'd love to have you subscribe, and we'd love to hear from you. Bye for now.